Four-game winning streak, right? Is this just Tyson Chandler or is something more going on here?
Tyson Chandler has helped Luke Walton be able to have a steady rotation. He's not having to play undersized centers in the second unit. He's not having to play a guy like Jonathan Williams, who's a nice young talent, but not necessarily NBA ready. And also, they beat up on some not-so-good teams, built their confidence up, and then are able to take that confidence against a very good team, against the Portland Blazers.
Why are you talking stuff about the Blazers?
No, but I mean Atlanta and Minnesota, who their house was burning down. And, you know, Sacramento has had some early wins, but they have more talent. It was like a college team. Syracuse, for years, got killed for playing cupcakes early. But guess what? By the time you play the good teams, you have the confidence going. Maybe that helped the Lakers.
So whoever out there had money on Dave dropping a Syracuse reference in his first 25 seconds on the show, you can go collect. Scotty, what do you think about what Dave's saying there?
Well, I buy into a lot of what he's saying. I think Tyson Chandler definitely has came in and anchored them on the defensive end, built their confidence. But let's not forget, this is a honeymoon stage for the Lakers, for Tyson Chandler. So, again, you have to see the competition that they are playing against. But they had a great win last night against the Portland Trail Blazers, which says a lot about their step and that they are making some kind of strides.
Yeah. And by the way, their poor start, there were a lot of one-possession games, those losses. Those are games that could have gone either way. And so the law of averages tells us most of the time it breaks both ways. And now we're seeing them win a lot of close. Think about that Atlanta game, for instance. That's a game that earlier this year they would have lost. And it just comes down to, did you get the call? Did you get a right bounce or what have you? So I think all those things are factoring in here.
Well, a game they did lose by just a point, I believe, right, was a LeBron free throw game. And we had a couple of those early on in this season. Yeah. Now, look, LeBron James made 13 of his 15 free throws last night. Earlier in the season also, Luke Walton complaining that wasn't getting calls. Do they feel like now he's getting calls? And what do you attribute? He's no longer, in LeBron's words, what do you say? My free throws are crap or something like that?
Yeah, trash or garbage.
Garbage, right. There we go.
There you go. Well, I mean, so it was a season high in attempts yesterday, which is obviously said something about his level of attack. But over the course of the season, the attempts has not been commensurate with the amount of attack style he's playing. Now, I talked to Tyson Chandler in the locker room after the game, and he's like, you know, he should get, and we'll see it here. He goes in and he draws contact. A lot of times he's so big and strong, it doesn't look like much, but it is. They're fouls. He earned the respect of the league to get those type of calls, which to me was really interesting because it was him basically saying, like, listen, if the coaches respect him, if the players respect him, why aren't the refs respecting him the same way? You mentioned Kyle Korver earlier in the show. Kyle Korver, who had been his opponent and his foe for so many times and losing to him, he used to think that, oh, man, this guy gets every call. And then having seen it up close, he told me, man, he never gets the calls he should get. And so I wonder if, this is the fatigue of LeBron.
Well, yes, but I don't know. As Amina said plenty on the show, Shaq never got the calls that he should have gotten. Scotty, I want to know if you and MJ felt you got the calls you deserved.
No, you better not.
No player ever felt like they get the calls that they deserve. But in defense for LeBron, he doesn't get a lot of calls that he do deserve. But he initiates a lot of the contact. So the official has to make some decisions sometime whether or not if it was the defender's fault or did LeBron really initiate the contact. And he's so big and strong and physical that it's very difficult for the official to see him alter, to even give him the calls because he's such a great finisher around the basket.
That's so for Shaq, it was, you know, when we had him, it was seeing it up close that he's going, and as you said, his course of action, his motion is not changing, but we could hear the of people just, there's no hand on leather. That's all flesh on flesh.
Right.
And he doesn't get the call. And when you got a guy that big, and by the way, that fast, he's moving fast, it's really hard, I mean, from a human element, for refs to perceive, oh, he got fouled right there.
Right.
And as I was talking to Tyson about it, he said, well, he doesn't. He was literally like genuflecting like this to show me that there's plenty of guys out there who do that.
I don't know who you're talking about.
Yeah, well, we won't name names.